这是最后一节，我们谈主耶稣的服事。
And this is our last class about the servitude of Jesus.
我们这一节要谈服事的传承。
And in this class, we will talk about the passing down of servitude.
在谈这个今天的题目之前呢，我们前几天有谈到主耶稣服事的能力啊，因为他在做工当中啊非常有果效。
And before we talk about that, we talked a little bit about how Jesus had power in his servitude and how everything he did was very effective.
讲道啊，非常有权柄。
And when he spoke with great authority.
哦，很多人很喜欢听他。
And many people like to listen to him.
啊，并且他讲道带着能力。
And when he spoke with power.
所以有很多人说啊，啊，这是一个新的道理吗？
And so some people said, is this a new truth?
啊，为什么耶稣的啊服事能够那么有果效？这个能力从哪里来？
And so why was Jesus' servitude so effective? Where did the power come from?
啊，我们祷告会的时候曾经谈到说，因为主耶稣很重视祷告。
And during one of the prayer sessions, we talked about how it's because Jesus looked heavily upon prayer.
啊，他在要开始服事的时候啊，禁食祷告，满得圣灵的能力。
And before he went out to go, before he started his ministry, he went and prayed and waited for the Holy Spirit to fill him with power.
他有时候天未亮就到旷野的地方祷告。
And sometimes he would go into the wilderness to go and pray.
有时候为着工作啊，整夜祷告。
And sometimes he would pray the entire night for the work.
啊，有时候常常在旷野，在家里到处啊，啊，都是很重视这个祷告的工作。
And everywhere that he was, he looked very heavily upon prayer.
哎，曾经跟门徒讲哈。
And he once also told his disciples.
要禁食祷告是得能力的一个秘诀。
To fast and pray is a secret way to receive power.
因为门徒啊，赶鬼赶不出去。
Because the disciples could not cast out some demons.
他们问耶稣说，原因在哪里？
And they asked him, and they asked Jesus, why could we not cast him out?
主耶稣说，这么凶的鬼啊，如果不祷告禁食啊，他就不出来。
And Jesus says that without fasting and prayer, this type of demon cannot come out.
哦，所以他知道这个祷告的秘诀啊，就是得能力的一个来源。
And so he knows that prayer is one of the ways of receiving power.
那另外一个就是他自己本身生活非常严谨。
And the other is that he was very controlled in his life.
神曾经对亚伯拉罕说，我是全能的神。
And God once told Abraham, I am Almighty God.
那所以你要在我面前做一个完全人。
And so you should be perfect before me.
那所以神的全能会临到一个完全人的身上。
And so God's power will come upon a perfect person.
那所以在雅各书里面说啊，义人的祷告啊，能够带来很大的功效。
And so in the book of James, it says that the prayer of the righteous man avails much.
啊，说以利亚其实就跟我一样性情的人。
And it says that Elijah is just a person like us.
为什么他求火又火，求雨又雨
？Why is it that when he prayed for fire, fire came down, and when he prayed for rain, rain came?
因为他有信心的祷告，迫切的祷告。
Because he had faith in his prayer and he prayed earnestly.
还有一个就是他是一个义人。
And another thing is that he is a righteous man. 所
以义人的祷告啊，那个大有功效。
And so the righteous man's prayer avails much.
那主耶稣的生活当中啊，他有几个值得我们学习。
And so in Jesus' life, there are some things that we should learn from.
第一个就是凡事啊，遵行神的旨意。
The first is to, in all things, honor the will of God.
哦，他以尽诸般的义啊，做好他一生当中生活的原则。
And he used the will of God as the principle in which by which he led his life.
尽诸般的义啊，就是福音啊，哦，罗杰梅斯，他要受洗的时候，他不是跟约翰说啊，我们要尽诸般的义。
And he said that we need to fulfill our righteousness.
啊。所以凡是神所要求的义啊，完全照着做。
And so all the righteousness which God requires of us, we must go and do.
所以他说，神所喜悦的，他就立志啊，行神所喜悦的事情。
And so he makes a determination to do all the things which are pleasing to God.
他曾叫一个 长大麻风的得医治。
He once healed a man of leprosy.
他常常行了神迹以后啊，叫人家不必为他传名。
And after he did many miracles, he often told them not to preach about.
那对这个病人特别告诉他说，你要按照摩西的律法。
But he told this leper that he needs to go and follow the law of Moses.
把你的身体去给祭司查看。
To show his body to the priests.
他证明说啊，你已经得到痊愈了。
To prove that you have been clean.
啊，然后按照律法的规定啊，献礼物啊，来向神感恩。
And to according to the law, make an offering and give thanks to God.
所以他说，我来啊，不是要废掉律法，而是要成全律法。
And so he said that I did not come to destroy the law, but rather to fulfill the law.
神的律法一点一划都不会废去啊。
And God's law, it will not go lay aside.
啊，当然不是说那个律法的字句，而是所律法的经义。
And of course, this is not to follow the word of the law, but rather to follow the spirit of the law.
但是我们今天也是一样啊，说为着神的缘故，也要顺服人一切的制度。
And so today is the same. We must also follow all the laws of man.
有的人说啊，这个规章为什么要守？
And some people may say, why do we have to follow these laws?
我为什么要照这个教员手册来？
And why do I have to follow according to the teacher's manual?
啊，那这个是一些规范。
And these are some These are some rules.
啊，因为这个都是按照圣经的精神来啊，让我们在处理事上有一个办法规则来做。
Because these are according to the Bible and how it gives us a structure which we can follow.
你如果不遵守制度啊，这整个团体啊就乱掉了。
And if you do not follow these structures, then the entire body becomes very chaotic.
你做你的，我做我的，啊，到底谁做的才对
？And if you do your way and I do it my way, then who is right?
啊，所以这个规则是大家讨论出来我们做事的一个原则。
And so these structures are, after discussion, we come up with this idea, this
principle. 当然这个 bylaw 不能够跟圣经比啦。
And of course, these bylaws are not comparable to the Bible.
啊，如果说违背圣经了，当然我们要改。
And of course, if they go against the Bible, we must change them.
啊，或者是我们觉得说啊，好像有些不太规定不太合理，那我们经过开会，我们就可以把它修订啊。
Or if we find that some are unreasonable, after going through a meeting, we can change them and modify them.
但是大家讨论出来的一些规则啊，我们不要去破坏它。
But we should not just go and break these laws that
we have discussed. 说就是社会上的规范也是一样。
And also the societal laws.
说为基督的缘故，我们要顺服人的制度。
And for the sake of Christ, we must follow man's authority.
我们虽然是神的儿女，但是我们也是地上的一个国家的国。
Even though we are children of God, we are also citizens of a nation on this earth.
我们一定要遵守国家的法律。
We must follow the laws of this nation.
所以当纳税，你要纳税，你要 pay taxes.
And we must pay taxes.
要缴税，你要缴啊，你不能够逃税啊。
And you must pay taxes. You cannot evade your taxes.
所以一些国家的法律，我们要守，我们不能够。违背国家的法律。
And so we must go according to our country's laws, and we cannot go against them.
所以基督徒啊，守法的精神呢，应该要比一般人更好。
And so Christians should follow the law even more than other people.
要守规则，守法律。
We must follow order and follow the laws.
啊，当然有一些在不住有的地方，有些规定跟我们信仰冲突的。
And of course, in certain areas, there may be laws that contradicts our beliefs.
啊，如果说这样的话，那当然我们要听从神啊，我们就不能够听从人呐。
And of course, this happens. We have to follow God. We cannot follow man.
但是一般来讲啊，这个社会的规范啊，这个规矩啊，我们都要遵守。
But normally, we must always follow the laws of this society as well.
主耶稣就是建筑般的，该做的正确的事情都照着去做。
So Jesus did all the things that he should do.
好，凡事行神所喜悦的事情。
And doing all things that are pleasing to God.
说为着要完成神的旨意啊，你要面对很艰难的环境。
And to fulfill God's righteousness, we must encounter these very difficult situations.
好像要面对十字架的苦悲。
For example, facing the death on the cross.
啊，虽然说啊，假如可以，我让我不要遇到这样的状况。
So he asked that if it is possible, let me not take this cup.
也假如还有别的方法可以来救人的话，请你把这个苦杯拿掉。
If there are other ways to save mankind, please take away this cup.
啊，但是不要照我的意思，只照你的旨意。
But not according to my will, but your will.
好。虽然我们人有我们人的想法
，and even though we all have our own thinking as man，
但是我们要知道，如果神要我们做的，虽然很艰难呢、啊，我们还是要靠着神帮助而来完成。
But、we must know that even if something is very difficult, and God, but God wants us to do it, we must do it with His help.
第二个就是他很爱慕神的话。
Second is that he loved the word of God very much.
从十二岁的时候啊，他就在圣殿啊，在那边跟教师啊谈论神的话。
From the age of 12, he started discussing the word of God with the teachers at the temple.
啊，虽然禁食四十昼夜啊，都已经肚子很饿了。
And even though he fasted for 40 days and nights, and he was very hungry already.
啊，但是受试探当中啊，他还是很坚守神的话。
But even though he was, when he was tempted, he still held on tightly to the word of God.
所以可以用神的话一个一个啊来击退撒旦的试探。
And so he could use the word of God to repel Satan's temptations.
他说他所讲的道理啊，都是根据神的话来。
And so everything that he spoke came from the word of God.
所以重视神的话。
And so he looked heavily upon the word.
另外一个就是保守心的圣洁。
The other is that he guarded his heart's purity.
啊，他在登山宝训的时候啊，告诉我们不只是这个诫命啦，只是说那个条文呐。
And in the Sermon on the Mount, he said that we should not just keep the
那个规条啊，那个注句啦，哈。
The letter of the law.
要紧的从内心里面啊，啊来所神的教训。
But the important thing is to, from within our hearts, to obey God's commandments.
比如说，不可以杀人，不只是你行动不可以杀人。
For example, when he says do not kill, he does not mean that you should only not physically kill someone.
我们从内心里面呢、啊，对人呢、啊、就没有恨。
From within our hearts, we cannot have hate towards another
person. 既然你对人没有恨呢、啊，你就不可能去杀人。
And if you do not have hate in your heart, there is no possible way you would go and actually kill
someone. 他说啊，不只是不可以犯奸淫呢。
And then it is not that we can only not commit adultery.
从我们的内心里面就不可以有淫乱的念头。
From inside our hearts, we cannot have these lustful thoughts.
所以他很注重这个心理的圣洁。
And so he looked heavily upon the purity of the heart.
So, 犹太人他们有很多啊洁净的规矩。
So the Jews they have very many laws about cleanliness.
要吃饭之前要很复杂的规矩洗手。
Before eating, you must wash your hands. It's a very complicated process.
常常啊，把那个器皿啊，哇，一直刷，一直洗。
And then their vessels, they will wash them over and over again.
但是耶稣说啊，从外面进去的不会污秽人。
But Jesus says that that which comes from the outside will not defile a man.
啊，当然，你如果不注重卫生啊，吃坏东西啊，有时候肚子痛啊，也会伤害身体嘛，哈。
Of course, if you eat something dirty and you may get a stomach ache and it will hurt.
啊，那这些脏的东西啊，都最后都排泄掉了。
But most of all of this will just pass through your system.
但是说啊，从内心里面出来的啊，会污秽人。
But that which comes from a man's heart will defile a man.
因为人的心里面常常充满着很多啊，诡诈、狡猾、嫉妒、纷争，各样不好的意念啊，充满在心里面。
Because oftentimes the things that will come out of a man's heart are corrupt and evil.
啊，所以这些法利赛人他们很注重这个形式外表的一些仪式。
And so the Pharisees they looked heavily upon the outer appearance.
啊，但是啊，他们看到主耶稣的工作跟流果效，心里就嫉妒，想要杀掉他。
But they saw that Jesus's work was very effective, and so they were jealous and wanted to kill him.
所以耶稣说啊，我们心理上的保守啊，心理上的洁净，比这个外表上形式上的洁净啊。更重要。
And so Jesus said that the cleanliness of inside is much more important than the outer cleanliness.
所以耶稣的工作会有果效。
And so Jesus' work would be very effective.
啊，他重视祷告，生活很严谨。
He looked very heavily upon prayer, and he was very careful with his life.
常常有神的同在。
And he often had God with him.
我们再来谈这个服事的传承。
So we'll also talk about the passing down of servitude.
传承就是啊，一代一代的传过去。
And so this is passing down from generation to generation.
耶稣在世界上传道理的时间相当短呢。
the time that Jesus spent on this earth preaching the gospel was very short.
3年多的时间。
It was only about 3 years.
但是他的这个工作却影响很大。
But this work that he did, it had a great impact.
当然除了说他的事迹非常伟大。
And apart from
他所做的事情影响到全世界。
And the things which he spoke and which he did, they impacted the entire world.
但是我们知道说，主耶稣能够选择门徒，把他的教训，把他的事迹，把他扩大，这也是很有关系。
But we know that Jesus was able to choose his disciples and to further spread the gospel in that manner, and that was also
因为这个门徒，一代一代的一直。 把神的道理传开来，会增加延续这个时间性。
Because through his disciples, they continuously preached the gospel, and it extended the period of time.
本来主耶稣传道的范围都是在巴勒斯坦地。Because
Jesus originally, when he preached, it was only in the land of Palestine.
那后来他们就从耶路撒冷、犹太全地到了外邦地方。
And then they preached from there until Judah, and then to other nations.
像保罗，就传到当时的那个地极，就是西班牙。
And so Paul, he preached to what was considered then the end of the world, which was Spain.
所以最后保罗说，再没有地方可以传了。 And
so Paul said, there's nowhere else he can go.
当时的世界这样。Because
at that time, that's all they knew.
那到了末世，这个范围更广，要传到普天下。
But at the end times, we must preach to the entire world.
那时候我们看到主耶稣一开始。 就是很注重这个接棒人，这个门徒的训练。
And so we see that Jesus was very carefully looking upon those who would take the baton next, his disciples.
我们看马可福音一章的16节。
And let's look at Mark chapter 1 verse 16.
马可福音一章16节。
Mark chapter 1 verse 16.
一章16节。
Chapter 1 verse 16.
耶稣顺着加利利的海边走， 看见西门和西门的兄弟安德烈在海里撒网，他们本是打鱼的。
17节。耶稣对他们说：“来跟从我，我要叫你们得人足矣。”18节。那么立刻死了，往跟从了他。19节。19。耶稣稍往前走，又见西比泰的儿子雅各和雅各的兄弟约翰在船上捕网。耶稣随即招呼他们，他们就把父亲西比泰和雇工人。
留在船上跟从耶稣了。这里主耶稣选召了两对兄弟。Here
Jesus has chosen two pairs of brothers.
彼得跟安德烈。Peter
and Andrew.
跟他们讲说，你们来跟从我，我要让你们得人如得鱼。He
said, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men."
所以他们就跟从主了。And
so they followed him.
另外。 对，看到约翰、雅各在船上捕网。And
then he saw James and John mending their nets in the boat.
主耶稣就招呼他们，也没有跟他们讲说，就招呼他们来，他们就离开他们父亲，就来跟从耶稣了。And
he called them, and then they left their father.
后来他们又，主耶稣又招了腓力啦、拿但业啦，拿但业一般讲，可能是巴多罗买啦，就是。
And then Jesus found Philip, and then he also found Nathaniel, who people say is also Bartholomew.
后来又选召了利未，那利未就是马太，就是马太福音的马太。He also got Levi, who was
Matthew, who wrote the book of Matthew.
所以主耶稣就一路上一直选召一些人来跟随他。And
so he kept going and finding more people to follow after him.
那我们如果整个福音书把它对照起来，And
so if we put all four Gospels together,
说这个约翰，这个安德烈他们本来是施洗约翰的门徒。And
if we look at John and Andrew, they were originally disciples of John the Baptist.
因为施洗约翰介绍说这是神的羔羊，所以他们就去跟随。
And so when John the Baptist said that this is the Lamb of God, then they went and followed Jesus.
安德烈就去找他哥哥彼得来。
And Andrew went to go find his brother Peter.
哦，那所以。 这些门徒啊，他们一开始啊，有一个选召的过程了、啊。当然，这边写的比较简单哦。
And so these disciples, they had a choosing, there was a process of them being chosen.
应该是他们先跟随啊，他们跟随耶稣做耶稣的门徒。
And so they followed Jesus first.
啊，路加福音啊，讲到这个啊，路加福音的第五章啊，谈到啊，主耶稣借彼得的船。
And in Luke chapter 5, it talks about how Peter, how Jesus, borrowed Peter's boat to preach.
啊，讲完道理以后啊，他就去啊，开船去捕鱼，结果捕了两船满满的鱼。
And after they preached, they went out and they fished and they caught two full boats.
啊，因为看到这个神迹啊，这个彼得他就放弃这些东西了，不再捕鱼了。啊、真正的就跟随主了。
And because of this miracle, then Peter left all of his fishing and followed Jesus.
好、哦，所以我们看到这个选召有一个过程了。
And、so we see that this choosing it has a process.、
啊、后来主耶稣曾经祷告整个晚上，啊、然后把门徒啊找来啊选了十二个。
And we also see that Jesus had prayed one entire night, and then he gathered his disciples and chose 12.
我们看路加福音第六章。
Let us look at Luke chapter 6.
路加福音六章。
Luke chapter 6.
十二节到十六节。
From verse 12 to verse 16.
六章十二节。那时耶稣出去上山祷告，整夜祷告神。十三节。
Verse 13.
到了天亮，叫他的门徒来。他就从他们中间挑选了十二个人，称他们为使徒。十四节。
14。
啊，这十四个人呢、啊，有西门，耶稣给他起名叫彼得，还有他的兄弟安德烈、雅各、约翰、威利、巴多罗买、马太、多马、亚勒威的儿子雅各、混锐党的西门、雅各的儿子犹大。还有最后一个是卖主的加利人犹大，哦，啊，这里讲到这个十二个使徒的名单呢、哦。
And here it is the names of all 12 disciples.
啊，这个名单里面第一个大概都是排彼得了。
And whenever they name them, usually the first one is named as Peter.
啊，最后一个就是卖主的犹大。
And the last one is the one who betrayed Jesus.
他说这些人呢、啊，是主耶稣整个晚上祷告完以后啊。才从他们当中选召出来的。
And so these 12, they were chosen by Jesus after he prayed for the entire night.
当中还出一个犹大来卖主、哦、
And amongst them was also Judas Iscariot who betrayed Jesus.、
哦、我们来看这个约翰福音。
Let's look at John.
约翰福音第一章。
John chapter 1.
约翰福音一章三十九节。
John chapter 1 verse 39.
约翰福音一章三十九节。
John chapter 1 verse 39.
从三十八节开始看。
Starting from verse 38.
三十八节。
Verse 38.
耶稣转过身来，看见他们跟着，就问他们说：“你们要什么？”他们说：“拉比在哪里住？”拉比翻出来就是夫子三十九节
Verse 39
耶稣说你们来看他们就去看他在哪里住、啊、这一天、啊、便与他同住、啊、那时约有深证嘛、哦啊、这里讲到说约翰的门徒听到约翰的见证以后、啊、就跟随耶稣
And so this is talking about how After John's disciples heard John's witness, then they followed Jesus.
跟在耶稣的后面。
And originally they were following behind him.
突然间啊，耶稣转过头来问他们说：“你们要什么？”
And then Jesus turned around and he said, "What do you seek?"
结果他们问说：“啊，拉比啊，老师啊，你住在哪里呀？”
And then they said to him, "Rabbi, where are you staying?"
啊，耶稣就带他们去看，结果他们就跟主耶稣同住了。
And then Jesus brought them with him, and then they stayed with him.
啊，这个约翰福音里面啊，好几个地方都谈到这个同住啊。
And in John, it often talks about how they remained with him.
啊，与主同住啊，这个很重要。
And to abide with God, it is very important.
啊，我们信耶稣最重要的目的啊，就是我们将来的归宿嘛。
And
我们就是我们将来要住的地方。
And this is where we want to live in the future.
我们就是要与主同住。
We want to live with God.
啊，要住在神的国里面，这是我们
To live in God's kingdom, this is our most important goal. And so Jesus asked them, what do you want? What do you seek?
他们就问说, 你住在哪里?
And so they asked him, where are you staying?
他们就说要跟主同住,
which means they wanted to abide with him. 当然从物质上来看啊,
主耶稣在地面上啊, 啊, 住的地方一定很简陋的。
And so from a materialistic standpoint, the where Jesus lived must have been a very simple place.
啊, 但是这些门徒能够跟他生活在一起, 跟他同住, 啊, 将来就能够在神的国里面啊, 能够跟主永远同住。
But these disciples were willing to live with him there, and so they will be able to live with him in eternity in the kingdom of God. Let us look at chapter 2, verse 12.
2章12节,
chapter 2, verse 12.
说这些事以后啊, 耶稣跟他的母亲、弟兄和门徒都下加百农去, 在那里住了不多几日。 哦，主耶稣行了第一个神迹，就是在迦拿的宴席嘛。
And the first miracle which Jesus performed was at the wedding in Cana.
啊，让水变成酒。
And he changed water into wine.
他说显出他的荣耀来。
And to show his glory.
啊，然后他们就来到了加百农。
And then they came to Capernaum.
啊，当然有耶稣跟他的母亲兄弟，啊说。 他说还有一些门徒，就跟他们跟耶稣啊住了一段时间。
So here he went with his mother, his brothers, and some of his disciples, and they stayed together.
我们看第三章。
And let's look at chapter
3:22。说这些事以后啊，耶稣和门徒到了犹太地，啊，在那里居住施洗。 有的人讲说啊，有人在问说啊，耶稣的门徒有没有受洗啊？
And some people ask, did Jesus' disciples get baptized?
然后他们后来都在帮人家洗礼呀。
And they eventually helped other people baptize.
哦，啊，有的人在研究说啊，这里可能就是耶稣为门徒施洗。
And some people say that here is where perhaps Jesus baptized his disciples.
啊，当然这里没有很清楚的。
Of course, it does not explicitly say here that Jesus baptizes his
disciples.
But it says especially that Jesus and his disciples came to the land of Judah.
And
they remained there and they baptized.
And
of course, Jesus and his disciples were there together and
baptized. And
so very possibly this is where Jesus' disciples
were baptized.
Because this was not external, this was with Jesus with his disciples.
And
if Jesus is not baptizing his disciples, then who is being baptized?
啊，这个门徒啊，为人家洗礼了。
And then in chapter 4, the disciples go and baptize others.
哦，我们看第四章的第一节跟第二节。
We look at John chapter 4, verse 1 and 2.
四章一节二节。
Chapter 4, verse 1 and 2.
主知道法利赛人听见他说门徒施洗比约翰还多。第二节。Verse
2.
其实不是耶稣亲自施洗，乃是他的门徒施洗。好，所以后来主耶稣也开始啊。 要开始传道了，啊，开始说门徒了。
And so Jesus was starting his ministry, and he was starting to gather more disciples.
啊，所以后来有很多人都到主耶稣那里接受洗礼。
And so many people came to Jesus to be baptized.
啊，这里说不是主耶稣亲自洗礼了，而是门徒来帮人家洗礼。
And here it says that Jesus himself did not baptize, but his disciples.
啊，所以如果这样连起来的话，可能前面那里是主耶稣跟门徒洗礼。 然后后来门徒公开的向众人洗礼。
And so if we put these two passages together, then it's very possible that Jesus baptized his disciples, and then now his disciples are baptizing others.
啊，当然这给我们做参考了哈。
Of course, this is just for our reference.
那主耶稣收了门徒以后啊，啊，一方面带着他们跟随他到各地方去传道哩。
And after Jesus had his disciples, he took them with him to go preach to various places.
啊，比如说一开始啊，带着他们到迦拿的婚姻的筵席上。
For example, first he brought them to the wedding in Cana.
因为他们看到耶稣所行的神迹啊，所以他们就信了。
And because they saw the miracle which he performed, then they followed him and believed in him.
后来主耶稣又带着他们经过撒玛利亚。
And then he brought them through Samaria.
啊，在那边跟那个妇人谈道理啊，那个他的门徒啊，他们后来都感到很稀奇。
And then they, he discussed with the woman, and then they all thought it was very, strange.
所以耶稣选召了这些门徒啊，啊，就让他们跟自己常常在一起。
And so these disciples were often together by themselves.
啊，听主耶稣讲道理，学习主耶稣的服事。
And they often listened to the words of Jesus, and they, experienced his service.
啊，然后主耶稣又差派他们出去。
And then Jesus sent them out.
啊，给他们。啊，医病赶鬼的能力。
And he gave them the power to heal the sick and to cast out demons.
哦，差派他们出去工作。
And he sent them out to go work.
我们看马太福音第十章。
We look at Matthew chapter 10.
马太福音第十章。
Matthew chapter 10.
马太福音第十章啊。
Matthew chapter 10.
第五节。
Verse
5. 一直到十五节。
From verse 5 until verse 15.
这里讲到说啊，主耶稣就差派门徒啊，叫他们往以色列家迷失的羊那里去。
And here, Jesus told his disciples to go out into the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
所以先跟他们讲说，外邦人的肚啦，撒玛利亚，暂时你们不要去了。
And he says, do not go into the way of the Gentiles and do not enter into the city of the Samaritans.
所以这个工作有一个先后。
And so this, the preaching, the work, it has an order.
先到那个以色列迷失的家那里去。
First, you go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
好，啊，一方面呢。一边走一边传道理，说神的国近了。
And as you go, you preach, saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
啊，然后医治病人呐、啊，叫死人复活。
And then you heal the sick and you raise the dead.
哦，一方面医病赶鬼行神迹。
And so they heal the sick, cast out demons, and perform miracles.
啊，然后说、啊、你们不必为生活忧虑，不必带口袋。
He says, do not worry about your life. You do not need to bring,
不必带另外带衣服,
you do not need to bring gold or silver or other tunics.
不必带金银铜钱,
and do not need to bring a bag for your journey.
因为工人得饮食啊, 啊, 传福音靠福音养生。
For a worker is worthy of his food. And,
所以你们到了一个城里面啊, 啊, 就打听哪一家是好人。
And so whenever you go into a household, you find a worthy household.
啊，然后你就去跟他问安。
And you greet them with peace.
啊，那个家庭如果配得平安呐、啊，这个平安就会临到。
And if they are worthy, then their peace will come upon this house.
啊，他接待你，啊，你就住在他们的家。
And if they receive you, then you can stay at their home.
人家摆上什么，你就吃什么。
And whenever they give you, you eat of it.
啊，你就在那边呐、啊，住在那里啊。一直传道理。
And then you live there, and then you can preach the gospel.
好、哦，啊，家属说没有人接待啊，啊，你们要走的时候就把脚上的灰尘啊跺一跺啊。
And whenever you are not received, then you just you shake the dust off your feet.
啊，所以告诉他们说，你们可以一方面传道理，啊，领受道理、领受恩典的人呐、啊，他们就要用物质的东西来。攻击你们生活上的需要。
And then, so he tells them that you should go and preach, and then those who are willing to receive you will give you your physical needs.
所以他说、啊、你不必为着生活忧虑啊，传福音啊，靠福音养生。
And so he says you do not need to worry about your life, but you will have your livelihood through this.
那保罗后来也是这样勉励啊。
And then Paul also encouraged in this manner.
那所以以前在南两的教会，他们认为说啊。啊，这个神的工人啊，不要有那个 full time 的专职的。
And so at a certain time, they said, they thought that preachers should not have a full salary.
他们说专职工人是雇工。
And they said that, and they said that it is a volunteer work.
啊，不是啦，那个约翰福音十章不是讲到那个有牧人，还有雇工，有盗贼吗
？A hired work.
因为雇工就是说你是看在钱的份上做工的啦。
Because if you are hired work, then you look at the money, and that's how you live.
哦，哎，因为羊不是他的啊，啊，所以危险来了他就跑掉了。
Because when the sheep are not his, when danger comes, he will run away.
以前在南两的教会认为说啊，拿薪水的就是雇工。
And so in the church they used to think that if you received pay, then you were like a hired worker.
啊，事实上不是这样。
But in reality, it is not so.
那说以前啊，很多的执事在讲道理啊，但是因为道理都没有深入。
And so some deacons, they were preaching in a church, and, but the truth they were preaching was not very deep.
所以对教会的造就有限。
And so the edification it had towards the church was very limited.
所以现在他们也是很多啊, 专主的工人。
And so now they also have many specialized workers.
可以把世上的事情，把世上的事物啊, 放下来, 专心啊。 啊，来做服侍神啊，牧养教会的工作。
Workers who can put aside all the things of this earth and then focus on pastoring the church.
啊，因为这样对教会才有真正的一些帮助哈。
Because of this, then they can truly help the church.
所以要有一些专主的功能。
And so we must have some specialized workers.
那这个保罗也谈到哈，说神说啊，牛在场上喘口的时候，你不可以把那个。 嘴巴把它拢住。
And so, and Paul also said that you should not muzzle an ox when it is out on the field.
他说神其实所顾念的不是牛啊。
And he says that God does not look upon the cow.
而是主着神的工人。
But he looks at his workers.
啊，你要他工作啊，你要照顾他的生活。
If you are, want him to work, then you must take care of his life.
啊，所以我们在教会里面有一个观念哦。
And so in church we have a principle.
我们 献身要服侍神的人啊，我们不要去计较那个生活待遇什么那个，我们不必计较。
For those who have offered themselves to be a preacher, then they should not.
我们不要说我一定要什么待遇。
They should not try and negotiate for their wages.
啊，但是呢，负责的人呐、啊，要关心这些工人的生活，让他们生活稳定。
But those in charge must make sure that their lives are very stable.
啊，让他们没有顾虑啊，可以专心来服侍神。
And let them live without worry, so that they can focus on serving God.
啊，所以这个负责的人呐、啊，那个角色不一样，他们所要注重的就不一样。
And so those who are taking care of this, they have different positions, so they take care of different aspects.
我们要服侍神呐。 你不必去计较说啊，我一个月要拿多少钱什么，不必计较这个的。And
when we serve God, we do not need to go and argue saying that I need this much per month.
我们看马太福音19章。
Let us look at Matthew chapter 19.
马太福音19章。
Matthew chapter 19.
27节。
Verse 27.
马太福音19章27节。
Matthew chapter 19, verse 27.
彼得就对他说：“看哪，我们已经背下所有的跟从你呀。” 啊，将来我们要得什么呢？哦，哎，有一个财主啊，说要得永生。And
there was a rich young man who said he wanted to receive eternal life.
啊，主耶稣说你要先守诫命。And
so he said you must first keep the commandments.
啊，然后说你把财产呐、啊、变卖掉啊，然后来跟从我。
And then he said, go and sell all that you have and follow me.
啊，后来这个人呢、啊，就忧忧愁愁就离开了。
And then the young man went away sorrowfully.
啊，主耶稣说啊，财主要进神的国很难呢。
And Jesus says that it is very hard for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven.
啊，彼得看到这个情形以后说啊，我们现在都已经所有的都憋气了，我们来跟随你。
And so Peter thought about it. He goes, well, we've already left all that we had now and follow you.
啊，那我们要得什么呢？
So what will we receive?
啊，然后主耶稣说啊，如果为我的缘故撇下房屋弟兄姐妹钱财的，今生得百倍，来世得永生。
And Jesus said that everyone who left houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother shall receive 100-fold and inherit eternal life.
啊，主耶稣就跟彼得说啊，你跟从我啊，一定有赏赐的啦，你不要挂虑这个生活问题啦。
And Jesus just told Peter that if you follow me, you will have your reward. You do not need to worry about these things.
今生得百倍。
You will have 100-fold.
来世承受永生。
And you will inherit eternal life.
但是主耶稣又加一句话说，但是许多在前的将要在后。
But then Jesus also said that, but many who are first will be last, and the last first.
所以主耶稣说啊，你所扶着驴啊，一直向后看的啊，不配进神的国了。
So Jesus said that those who hold on to their donkey and keep looking back are not fit to enter the kingdom of God.
啊，你要服侍神啊，一样挂虑说啊，我生活有没有问题啊，啊，我能够得到什么？
If you keep serving God, but you keep trying to look back and trying to think about what you will receive.
啊，因为你有很多的顾虑啊，你就没有办法一直的专心来服侍神。
And because you have these many worries, then you cannot focus on serving God.
所以跟随主的赏赐是大的。
And so following God, the reward is great.
生活上是没有问题的。
You do not need to worry about your life.
我们不必顾虑。
We do not need to worry.
啊，那主耶稣就接下来就讲这个。 马太福音二十章的这个比喻啦。
And then Jesus went on to talk about the parable in Matthew chapter
20. 他讲到说啊，这个葡萄园里面啊。工作很多，要很多工人。
And then he talks about how in the vineyard they needed many laborers.
他所以就先跟那些工人讲，你为我做一天呐，我给你一块钱。
And so he went out.
一钱的银子。
He went out and hired people and said that we will I will hire you for one piece of.
这个人就进来就工作了。
And so these people came in and they started working.
哎呀，这个葡萄园很多很大。
And because this vineyard was very big and great.
所以要很多很多的工人。
So they needed many people.
然后啊，他又到街上去，看到有的人啊在那闲站，说你们就继续的找工人进到这个葡萄园。
And so he went out again and he found more people who were standing idle, and so he brought them in to go work at his vineyard.
没有跟他讲说要多少钱呢。
He did not tell them how much he would pay them.
说你们进来工作，我该给的我会给你们。
And he says, you come and work, and whatever is right, I will give you.
这些人呢，他们也没有计较，就进去工作了。
And so these people did not complain or anything, they just went in and worked.
早上一大早啊。六点有人进去，九点有人进去。
And so some people started at 6 in the morning, and some people started at 9 in the morning.
十二点啊，下午三点，最后啊，五点都还有人进来。
And then 12, and then 3, and then even late until 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
到了晚上啊，六点啊，就发工钱啦。
And at night at 6 o'clock, it was time to pay the wages.
就从那个最后来的开始发。
And they started with those who had come in last.
这个人只做一个小时。
And some of these only worked about 1 hour.
主人就给他一钱。
And they received a denarius.
然后他就很高兴啊，做一个小时就拿一块钱，银子就回去了。
And so they're very happy. They worked 1 hour and they received a denarius. So they went back.
三点的、十二点的也是拿一钱。
And those who started at 3 and those who started at 12 also received a denarius.
到了那个最早来的那个六点来的，他也是拿一钱。
And starting all the way until those who started at 6 o'clock, they also received the denarius.
结果他就抱怨了。
And so they complained.
他本来以为说啊，我人家做一个小时啊，就拿一块钱了、那我做了十二个小时，我应当拿更多啊。
And they said that these men who only worked 1 hour, they have received a denarius. I should receive more.
他就对那个主人啊，就开始抱怨了。
And so they started complaining to the master.
主人说，朋友啊，我没有亏待你哦。
But the master says, friend, I am doing you no wrong.
你跟我讲好的是一块钱哦。
Did you not agree with me for a denarius?
所以我要给别人多一点啊，那是我的自由啊。
And so if I want to give somebody more, what it is my own prerogative.
你跟我讲一块钱，我就给你一块钱啊。
And I said I would give you a dollar, and I gave you a dollar.
所以我们有时候服侍神啊，跟神斤斤计较，我要什么我要什么。
And so sometimes we complain to God, and we say, I want this or I want that.
你会计较的人不见得得到比较多嘞。
Those of you who complain may not receive more from God.
你看人家不讲话，就默默的就进去工作。
And some people they do not say anything and they just go in silently and work.
但是主人给他的就更多啊。
But the master gives more to them.
所以我们服侍神啊，一定有赏赐的。
And so when we serve God, we will receive a reward.
但是啊，我们不要在服侍当中啊计较，我要待遇，我要什么啊什么福利啊。
But when we work, we should not say that I want this or I want that.
忠心的服侍啊，做主的仆人啊，主一定赏赐的。
And if we faithfully work for God, then God will reward us.
虽然我们一般都是义工哈，我们也没有得到什么物质上的利益。
And even though it is, we are mostly volunteers and we do not receive material compensation.
但是我们知道，我们工作的果效会随着你。
But we know that the fruits of our labor will follow us.
将来按照你所做的工作啊，从主那里得赏赐。
And the end, when we will receive a reward from God according to our fruits.
我要得到那个荣耀的冠冕。
And we shall receive this crown.
我们知道主耶稣一定是很公义的。
And we know that Jesus is very fair.
我们为主服侍啊，绝对不会落空。
And if we serve God, we will not leave empty-handed.
所以我们不要去计较说哇，谁不做谁不做。不做是他跟神的关系的。
And so we should not complain that this person doesn't do anything or that person doesn't do anything. That
但是将来的赏赐是我们跟神之间的关系。
But then the reward in the end is between us and God.
这是我们在服侍当中应当有的正确观念。
And this is an accurate mindset we must have.
我们看到主耶稣在选召了这些门徒，给他们很多的实际上的工作的一些操练。
And so we see that Jesus gave his disciples a lot of practical work to do.
所以我们要学习服侍神啊， 我们也是一样，接受各样的工作的锻炼。
And so when we also want to serve God, we must also go through the training of many different types of service.
我在南加州工作的时候啊。
And when I was working in Southern California,
有时候出去访问弟兄姐妹。
Sometimes we go out to go visit the brothers and sisters.
有时候有一些青年啊，就陪着我们出去访问。
And sometimes some youths would come and join us.
所以他们可以在这个跟传道者在访问工作当中，我想多少他们都随可以学到很多服事上的一些事情。
And as they came along with us, I'm sure that they learned a lot from all the preachers and the way that they serve.
所以我们在地方教会也有很多很多我们可以学习可以参与的侍奉工作。
And so in our local church, there are also many different types of works that we can join in.
比如说家庭聚会的带领啊。
For example, leading family services.
各样的访问啊。
For different visitations.
比如说到信徒家到医院。
To go to members' houses or to go to the hospital.
但是我看有些青年哦，晚上不参加聚会。
But I find that sometimes some youth do not go to the evening services.
有时候很少在做访问工作。
And they very often do not go.
其实很多的侍奉工作啊，我们都要参与。
They do not go for visitations, and so we must often go and try different work at different works, and then we can be a better help. And many churches they have different teams that do different
whole works. 虽然这个小事情啊，但是我们要学习小事上就忠心。
And even though these are small things, we must learn to be faithful in the small things.
好像这个门徒啊，他们也是平常的工作开始学习。
Like the disciples, they started from everyday things.
我们看一下《路加福音》。
Let us look at Luke.
第十章。
Chapter 10.
路加福音第十章。
Luke chapter 10.
我们看十七到二十节哈。
Let us look at verse 17 to verse 20.
这主耶稣另外差派七十个人出去工作。
Here Jesus has sent out 70 more.
当然主耶稣要他们工作啊，都会给他们权柄的。
And when he sends them out, of course he will give them power.
主耶稣要我们工作啊，他也会给我们恩赐。
And so when Jesus wants us to work, he will also give us talent and the ability.
那七十个人啊，高高兴兴就回来了。
And so these 70 returned with joy.
他们对主耶稣讲，哇，主耶稣啊，你的名很好用哎。
And they said that your name is very good to use.
我们奉你的名赶鬼，魔鬼都怕我们呢。
And even the demons are subject to us in your name.
主耶稣啊，对他们提醒说，不要因为鬼附了你们就欢喜。
And then, but Jesus reminded them, do not rejoice because the demons listen to you.
要因为你的名啊记在天上来欢喜。
But rejoice because your names are written in heaven.
这个是告诉我们这个侍奉啊跟灵修两个都很重要。
And so this tells us that both our servitude as well as our spiritual cultivation
are both very important. 我们在侍奉当中，神会给我们恩赐。
In our servitude, God will give us the talents.
真的有时候啊，让你这个工作啊能够做得很好啊。有很好的成果。
And sometimes he gives us the talent so that we can do the work very well and have good results.
那不是不要因为我们有了一些成果啊，我们就觉得自己很了不起，就骄傲自大起来。
But we should not because of these results become proud.
因为这个恩赐啊，是神赐给你的，是要来帮助圣工啊，彼此造就的。
Because these gifts were given to us by God to help with the holy work.
但是这个恩赐能力啊。圣工的果效没有办法保证你得救。
But these gifts and these the results of your holy work does not necessarily mean that you will receive salvation.
所以有的人啊，医病赶鬼行神迹啊，后来主耶稣说我不认识你们了。
And so some people will heal the sick and cast out demons, but Jesus in the end will say that I do not know you.
因为他们虽然有能力做工啊，但是灵修不好。
Because even though they have power, their spiritual cultivation is not good.
所以最后就被神拒绝了。
And so at the end they will be rejected by God.
我们在侍奉当中啊，要注重我们的灵修。
And so in servitude we must make sure we must be careful of our spiritual cultivation.
我常常也会攻克己身。
And so Paul also said that he always he disciplines his body.
因为我怕说我传福音给别人，我自己后来反而被神拒绝了。
Because he does not want to, he's afraid that he will preach to other people, and then at the end he will be rejected.
就是我们应当有的提醒。
And this is a reminder we must have.
我们谈到这个侍奉当中的一些考验哦。
And we talk about some of the trials that we come into during our servitude.
看马太福音第十章。
Let us look at Matthew chapter 10.
马太福音十章二十四节。
Matthew chapter 10 verse 24.
就从十六节开始啊，都是主耶稣对他们的提醒。
And so starting from verse 16, it is reminders from Jesus Christ.
说你们啊,好像那个羊啊,进到狼群里面。
He says that I send you out as sheep in the midst of wolves.
因为有人啊,有很多人啊,好像豺狼一样,随时都要把我们吞吃掉呢。
Because there's many people there who are like wolves and want to swallow us up.
所以在侍奉当中啊,要灵巧,要寻良。
And so in our service, we must be gentle and shrewd.
因为有人啊,可能会逼迫你们,诽谤你们,甚至想要伤害你们。
Because there will be people who want to harm you and even kill you.
所以我们要寻良,但是也要灵巧,要防备人。
And so we must be harmless, but also wise, and be able to beware of men.
当然说啊, 这个24节说,学生没有办法高过先生。
And then in verse 24, it says that a disciple is not above his teacher, nor a servant above his master.
他说学生先生都是一样啊。
And then
25节啊, 说人家既然骂这个家主是别西卜, 何况是他的家人。
人家没有骂主耶稣说他是靠着鬼王别西卜在干鬼的。 And people had called Jesus saying that he casts out demons by the power of Beelzebub.
主耶稣在传道里都说到处受辱骂,到处受攻击。
And as Jesus went out, he was persecuted and he was attacked.
很多人一直想要把他杀掉。
And many people wanted to kill him.
所以他说,老师所遇到的学生也会遇到了。
And so he said that which the teacher encounters, the students will also encounter.
所以主耶稣他在传道里当中所遇到的挑战呢, 我们不是他的人,
and so the difficulties which Jesus faced in his ministry, we will also face.
但是我们不要怕,
but we should not be afraid.
他说,会那个杀身体,不杀灵魂的, 你不要怕他。
And do not fear those who can harm your body but cannot harm your soul.
就是再大的逼迫啊, 我们也不要怕。
Even the greatest persecution, we do not need to be
afraid. 因为他顶多把你的生命杀掉。
Because at most, they will take away your life.
但是啊, 我们做体力士了, 我反而能够得到那个, 更荣耀的冠冕。
But once we leave this life, we will be able to receive that more glorious crown.
所以不怕。
And so we should not be afraid.
但是啊, 因为我们是神的仆人啊, 神都会特别保守看顾。
But because we are also the servants of God, then he will look after us.
他说就是你在被审判的时候, 你不必事先想说你要讲什么话。
And so when we are being judged, we do not need to think about what we will say before.
到时候, 圣灵会主教你该说的话。
But at the time, the Holy Spirit will direct you in what you should speak.
过去啊, 曾经有那个我们教会的长辈啊, 被那个日本宪兵抓去。
And there was this elder of our church who was once taken captive by the Japanese soldiers.
这个宪兵问他说, 你们说人都有罪啊, 日本天皇有没有罪?
And so they asked him, you say that men have sins, does the emperor of Japan have sin?
你如果跟他讲说有罪啊, 马上触刀就给你触下去了。
And if you say yes, then they'll just stab you with their bayonets.
圣经里面说人都有罪啊, 日本天皇有没有罪? 我不知道。
And he said that the Bible says that everyone has sins. If the Japanese emperor has sins, I do not know.
那个人也没有办法,那个宪兵也没有办法对他怎么样。
And so the soldier could not do anything to him.
以前在那个上海总部啊, 我们上海以前的总部很大。
And before,
好像四层楼还是五层楼。
We also had a,
上海,
in Shanghai we had a GA building.
那个是我们自己盖的,里面也有我们的印刷厂。
And it was very big, and it was a four-story building, and we even had our own printing press inside.
那个时候战争的时候,日本军队就在我们上海总部的前面。
And during the war, then the Japanese soldiers stood right in front of our building.
到我们里面有人啊,就开枪啊,扫射。
And they would just look up and see if there was anybody there, and they would just shoot at them.
后来进去的时候啊,我们一些主事啊,本来在那边工作的, 都被绑起来,绑在那个庭院。
And when they were, and when they went in, then they tied up some of the deacons who were working there.
当中有一个台湾的执事叫张傻家。
And at that time, there was a deacon there, a deacon Cheng.
他的女儿现在还在上海。
And his daughter right now is still in Shanghai.
因为他会日本话，跟他们讲啊，沟不通。
And he knew how to speak Japanese.
但是跟那个日本军人讲不通。
But he could not talk with these Japanese soldiers.
所以他们就要开枪了。
And so they were about to shoot them.
结果他们就祷告啊。
And so they started praying.
祷告圣灵充满。
And they were filled with the Holy Spirit.
有一个日本军官跑过来说，什么是哈利路亚？你们在做什么？
And then one of the soldiers ran over and said, "What is this hallelujah? And what are you guys doing?"
后来说，哎，这是好人呢。
And then he said, "These are good people."
然后就把他们放掉。
And then they let them go.
带一个兵啊，有一个兵啊，就把他们带到那个驻留的地方去。
And then they had an escort all the way to the safe area.
好，啊，这个是我们教会早期啊。这个已经发生七十年了，在七十年纪念的时候，那个专栏里面有这样的啊资料哈。
And this was recorded in the 70-year anniversary.
1931年的事情。
And then this happened in 1931.
好，那所以说啊，我们的头发，我们的头发，主耶稣都给你算过。
And so it says that.Every hair on our head, Jesus has counted.
啊，如果主耶稣不允许的话，一根也不会掉。
And if Jesus does not will it, then not even one hair will fall.
主耶稣说，我们比那个飞鸟啊贵重多了。
And Jesus says that we are much more precious than the flying birds of the air.
啊，如果主耶稣不允许啊，那个雀鸟也不会掉了。
And if Jesus does not will it, then not even a bird will fall from the sky.
啊，说我们既然是主的仆人呐，啊。主一定会保守看顾。
And since we are the servants of God, then God will look after us.
啊，就是最后主耶稣愿意我们为主耶稣殉道，啊，我们也能够承受更大的福气。
And Jesus wants us to martyred, and to be martyred for Jesus and to have enter His glory.
啊，好像彼得啊，后来就是为主殉道而死。
Like Peter, he was martyred for Jesus Christ and he died.
好像保罗一样。
Like Paul.
哦，保罗在。腓立比书第一章里面讲说他还在两难之间嘛。
And Paul had said that he was in a hard place.
他本来是说如果能够离世啊，跟主有同住很好。
And he said to die is really good because he can go and
live with Christ. 我现在还不会死。
But he says I will not die now.
因为我留着对教会还很重要。
Because for me to live, it is still very important to the
church. 所以虽然被关在监里啊，随时都可能被杀掉，但是他知道说我不会死。
And so he, even though he was in prison and he could be killed at any moment, he knew that he would not be killed.
因为他知道啊，很清楚知道说神还有工作要让他做。
Because he still very clearly knew that God had work for him to do.
啊，所以如果说啊，我们呢、啊、知道神有使命在我们身上。虽然你遇到很大的危险呢，不会死的。
And so if we know that God still has a mission for us, then even if we encounter something very dangerous, we will not die.
好，因为神要我们工作。
Because God wants our work.
啊，如果说啊，我们活着啊，但是我们没有什么使命啊。
But if let's say that we live and we do not have any mission,
也没有什么意义。
Then our life does not have any meaning.
啊，我们活着好像也白活，没有意义。
If we live, it is meaningless still.
啊，我们就谈到这里，我们一起默祷。
We'll end here. Let us bow our heads and pray in silence.